Welcome everybody to another episode of Pokemon Advanced Adventures. I worked out how to get onto the 11th floor, so I decided to start from there. I see Ben in a Pokeball, so I'm going to get us ready because I think we're about to run into our rival again. Well, clearly we are because he's right here, so... Can we pass by him? So there is another route, okay. Johnny, you are really starting to get on my nerves. It will not stop me. The Pokemon world will be under my absolute control. I will take over the world by controlling the Pokemon HQ. Then when that happens, no one will stop me. Both of our fates have been decided. It just so happens that I got a bit more lucky. So here we are. We're battling Ben again. He's got a Shiftry now. So I'm going to use Ice Punch to wipe out his Shiftry. Got a Rhyhorn, I think we can handle that as well. You've got a Numel. Now that's gonna be an issue. That one's on Seek and Ice. That one's for Seek and Ice and Surf. Got a Jolteon, that's... haven't really got anything that can handle that. I suppose that's T-1000, isn't it? At least for the first hit, and then it's Thunderlips. Finish it off with Sergeant AWOL. Right shape, sorry. Shit, he's absolutely slaughtering us. Okay, Seekanine, you better be able to finish this. Damn it! He's absolutely kicking our ass. Rufflet, can you fly? No, Rufflet weren't quick enough either. We lose to Ben and his Jolteon. I wish we still had our bloody grenade, but... Sergeant AWOL, is there anything you can do? You're a bug type, so... That's not gonna bother you. Takedown did it? They can have a pin missile, knock him out with a tackle attack. And he's got a knockdown. Have we got any revives? No. So it's just you against this pissing knockdown then. Oh well, we'll be back. Pathetic, you will never stop me. I'm gonna buy some revives, I think. That's the first time we've whited out since this became a non-Nuzlocke, so it's good to know we were alright. Let's go back and face Ben once more. This time we're going to win though, because we're going to use item hacks. So I'll just show you guys the route that I took. Onto the from here to the second floor, the third floor, sorry. Then you take this far left on here, the path follow you all around, take you up to here on the fourth floor. When you get to the fourth floor, you go up and you go across here. Now you get to this section. You want to go onto this one, which will take you down. You've got to beat all four of them trainers and go onto this route here, which takes to the 11th floor of the mansion. Along here and here then. So let's do this fight now, Benjamin. Shift tree is still not going to be a problem. Ice punch will wipe it out, no problem at all. Right horn will have the same fate. I'm going to try it with normal. Normal nearly had the same fate. But I'm not going to waste Seeker 9 on normal because Ruffler can finish the job. Thunder Lips and Ice Beam. You can keep doing some of that move if you want. Because I can hit you with another Ice Beam. And freeze you solid. I'll follow up with another Ice Beam and put you down then. You're still out of it. Sorry, Jolteon. And he's got a Knocked Owl, of course. Knocked Owl probably won't like a jolt of lightning up its backside. But it manages to get pull off that move and get me to sleep, so I'll switch to Ice Shade. We can smash it. With an Ice Punch. And put it down! Down goes Knocked Owl. T-1000 can get rid of Pursuit and learn Faint Attack. This is not the last time you will see me for now. Have fun trying to take down my subordinate and his Pokemon. Watch your back, Johnny. So, we need to heal up desperately before we even consider fighting that Shadow Pokemon. Because he's left his subordinate in the gym, and there's also this Tyrant Pokemon he's left on the... Well, I assume it's a Tyrant Pokemon, right? I mean, we came here to deal with a Tyrant Pokemon that was at the top of the tower, so... Johnny discovered the Pokemon causing trouble in the town. It seems as if it's resting. It's a Claydol! Wow. It's a red Claydol. Red, it's a Claydol that's red, okay. Shadow Punch. The Claydol's obviously got its psychic moves. You're coming in the party though, you are good. Go roughly. Go Great Ball. At the moment it's only used Psychic and Psybeam, so we can't see anything different about it. But I'm assuming it's picked up Fire Typing or something. Poison. She's Poison Gas. But a lot of Psychics can actually do that, so... It's got Toxic as well. So it is part Poison and Psychic. That's a good Pokemon to have in the party, I want that. And we got it! We caught Claydol! I'm gonna call it Blood Blade. So we've beaten the clay doll, but we are poisoned, so let's get out of here pretty damn quick. That route's just straight to the exit, great. And we're outside. Now then, we can go back to the Spooky Center and get rid of Sergeant AWOL, replace him with our Blood Blade. Let's check him out. He's Poison Psychic, Psybeam Toxic, Poison Gas, and Psychic. That is one. That is a decent Pokemon, that is. I wonder what the, is it a Psychic gym here? I mean, Saffron, or whatever usually is, but... Okay then. What you got? Yep, it's psychic, alright. So we've got a psychic gym. I'm gonna wipe this guy out. I can see this being a very long gym. So I don't know the route, do I? But what I'm going to do is I'll see you guys back in a little while. I'm going to clear the room. Hang on. Back. Found my way to the gym leader. Well, hello. There's no need to tell me your name. I already know it. I was born with psychic abilities and I foresee a horrible future for you, Johnny. Allow me to put you out of your misery. It's Sabrina or Sabby. Subordinate Sabby sent out Slowking. Just punch it in the face then. Punch it in the face 2 times. Punch it in the face again. You're asleep now, Eyeshade. Wake up, Eyeshade. Quite important to this battle. Go 2-1000 and faint attack. You can fight for a bit, 2-1000. Dark attacks are pretty good. Shadow Ball ain't gonna work on you because you're a normal type. This is gonna be a slow death, but it'll be something that will work against Gardevoir. One of the Pokemon named to be a fairy type in the upcoming X and Y. Well, here's an Alakazam. I imagine him and that Recover could be annoying, to say the least. Raising physical defense ain't gonna help you, mate. Super potion's gonna help you, though. That time you did an attack that actually hurts me. You'll go down eventually, because you'll run out of uses of that revive. With recover and... then you'll be stuck to using the one or two potions gym leaders are entitled to carry. You're back to full health, crap. Okay, Bloodblade, I choose you. You're toxic. Damn it, Bloodblade! Ruffle it, step out. It's just a sacrifice at this point, mate. I've got to get Ice Shade back on the field. And you exist to hang on until I can do so. So I can crack him with a Shadow Punch and put him out of his misery. Deaconine's up to 26. And closing with an Espeon. Pure Psychic again, so... Oh, you were quicker. Go Deaconine. Thunderlips, go. Let's get Ice Shade to full health. Then use Ice Beam. Ice Shade, you're up. Shit! I lost to the leader again. Okay. Balls. Alright. You got lucky. I'll see you back at the battle. So I'm back fighting the Espeon again. And there we go. We beat that. You may have defeated me, but you'll never defeat Ben. Ha ha ha! Farewell, Johnny! We got the badge from Sabby. So let's get the heck out of here. Out of this gym full of crazed Yuri Geller fans and go and heal up. Because we've got another badge for our collection. Which is always good, you know? See if we can find this town's police force, because they normally give you things when you clear out Ben, so. I do this for reward, so. Johnny, you truly are a hero. Please go forth and take this. TM29. That's psychic. Oh, actually, yeah. Teach Earthquake, too. Oh, yeah, he's not compatible anymore because he's not he's not ground type, is he? He used to be a ground type, you see, a clay doll, but. But we can surf on Seekanine's back and find Wild Seedras. And Quagsires. It's also raining on the water. It's gonna mean it's gonna be decisively choppy. I'm gonna surf around in stages to try and avoid the train battles. And one more. I'm in the Village of Water. Our town has been terrorized by a Pokemon that rules the sea. They have taken and turned him into a fire-breathing monster. Most of the town's people have fled due to the fear, including my family. Please rid our town of this horrible, horrible monster. So there's a water-type Pokemon that's been turned into a monster, eh? And I think that's something we can deal with. We found it. So let's go and do it, shall we? It's a Gyarados! Wow! We've already had a Gyarados. It's an orange Gyarados! Interesting. So it's a Gyarados with fire subtype. Or will it be a dragon subtype? Well, let's try Ice Punch and see. Ice Punch didn't work on it, but it did freeze it, which is good. But it was defrosted immediately. It's got Water Pulse. We essentially need to sort of take a few hits and see what it's capable of. It's got Hydro Pump and it took out Ice Shade. I'm going to send in T-1000 because he's more bulky. Let's go and return attack. I'm going to start trying to capture it. We got it. So we captured this Gyarados. I'm going to call it Gingados. I've got a Ginge. No, I think Weasley actually. Let's call it Weasley. Oh, we could actually call it. Yeah, let's call it Ron Weasley. Enough letters to call it Ron Weasley, so it means we have to, right? So now we've captured it. Let's go have a look at it. And see what it is. It's gonna release the other Gyarados. So it's fire and water. Crunch, flame wheel, water pulse and hydro pump. I'm not sure why they did that. Because we've already got a fire water type. What's its stats? 89.56. What about could it be worth swapping RC Canine it out for it? That's the question there. Oh, it's much stronger than Sea Canine. What thing does it have? What's its ability? Intimidate, yeah, it's basically just a leveled up, quality, strong, strengthened version of Sea Canine, right? So I think we're retiring Sea Canine. No sense in having both. And we got our Surf HM, so we can teach it Surf as well. So we can Surf on Ron Weasley now. And give me the Crunch. We'll teach it Flamethrower as well, because it's fire type, so. We may as well use Ron Weasley instead of Sea Canine, because it's got a stronger attack and stuff. So let's sell some stuff here then. any turns we don't plan to use. We've already got something that's, that learns that. The rest of them gone. Whatever. There's loads of TMs, isn't there? And that's what it meant by lose your TMs, obviously, thing fucks up from time to time. I'm gonna keep the stones because you never know. Do you really? But so much for deciding he was gonna learn Earthquake because he's lost it. Let's make our way down to the gym. Possible turn to this tower. They say thousands of years ago, a legendary Pokemon was locked in it so it could never escape and turn out of the real world. Rumor has it only two keys were made at once. Once it was destroyed. Oh, that's what we're new to, isn't it? There's a gym in this game then. I mean, there must be a gym, right? Well, I think it's time to wrap up. Wrap up this episode of Pokemon Advanced Adventures. In the next episode, we're gonna try and find the gym in this town and challenge the gym leader to... Oh, here we go, found the gym. In the next episode, we'll challenge the gym. See you guys then. You've got a Numel. Now that's going to be an issue. That one's on for Seek and I. That one's for Seek and I and Sir. You've got a Jolteon. That's I haven't really got anything that can handle that. I suppose that's T-1000, isn't it? At least for the first hit, and then it's Thunderlips. They can have a pin missile and knock him out with a tackle attack. And he's got a knockdown. We've only revived. No. It's just you against this pissy knockdown then. Oh well. We'll be back. Ha, pathetic. You will never stop me. I'm gonna buy some revives, I think. That's the first time we've whited out since this became a non-Nuzlocke, so. Welcome everybody to another episode of Pokemon Advanced Adventures. I worked out how to get onto the 11th floor, so I decided to start from there. I see Ben in a Pokeball, so I'm going to get us ready because I think we're about to run into our rival again. Well, clearly we are because he's right here, so... Can we pass by him? So there is another route, okay. Let's walk up to him. Johnny, you are really starting to get on my nerves. You will not stop me. The Pokemon world will be under my absolute control. I will take over the world by controlling the Pokemon HQ. Then, when that happens, no one will stop me. Both of our fates have been decided. It just so happens that I got a bit more lucky. So here we are. We're battling Ben again. He's got a Shiftry now. So I'm going to use Ice Punch to wipe out his Shiftry. He's got a Rhyhorn, I think we can handle that as well. And finish it off with Sergeant AWOL. Right, Shade, sorry. Shit, he's absolutely slaughtering us. Okay, Seeker 9, you better be able to finish this. Damn it, he's absolutely kicking our ass. Rufflet, can you fly? No, Rufflet weren't quick enough either. We lose to Ben and his Jolteon. I wish we still had our bloody grenade, but... Sergeant AWOL, is there anything you can do? You're a bug type, so... That's not gonna bother you. Takedown did it? It's good to know we're alright. Let's go back and face Ben once more. This time we're gonna win though. Because we're gonna use item hacks. So I'll just show you guys the route that I took. Onto the from here to the second floor. Third floor, sorry. Then you take this far left on here, the path follow you all around, take you up to here on the fourth floor. When you get to the fourth floor, you go up and you go across here. Now you get to this section. You want to go onto this one, which will take you down. You've got to beat all four of them trainers and go onto this route here, which takes the 11th floor of the mansion. Along here, and here's Ben. So let's do this fight now, Benjamin.